What do you want? Leave us alone.
Hey guys, it's Jeff Lafferty, and it's the Artcast. Let's do some work. I'm sorry if my voice sounds a little weird, but I got a cold that I can't shake. Yeah, I can't get rid of this sucker. It's been hanging on for a couple weeks, but anyway, time to do the Artcast. So let's do it. Let's fight through it. So I wanted to show you guys like what I've been animating with the mouse shapes. And getting the berserker not to talk. That was my whole plan for this week. But I haven't got it done yet. So I'm going to hold that back till next week. And this week here, I just got some footage of me doing some sketches inside the front cover of my comic, The Berserker Not, which is still amazingly available at Indiegogo. If you guys want to go buy a copy of it, it's still there. And that's where I sell it. And I'll do a sketch if you order that tier. I thought I'd talk a little bit about this whole debacle, or I should give the warning, you know, jump in the trenches and get the helmets and get down low, because I'm going to go on a comics gate rant. No, I'm kidding. This isn't really a rant, but I am going to talk about this whole Tess Fowler, Doug Tenaple, and Sean Gordon Murphy fiasco. Happened here lately on the internet. If you don't know the story, basically Tess Fowler was on who I guess is a DC writer, I guess. I don't know. Is she a writer or an artist? I should look that up and check. But she don't like Doug Tenaple, and I guess she don't like Sean Gordon Murphy either. Anyway, she was on Twitter talking about how Doug's a homophobe and all that good stuff, which I guess he is. I don't know. He's one of these Christians that goes off, you know, if you're going to be a Christian, you can't be gay. So, I mean, that's how he looks at it, not how I look at it, but, you know, hey, to each his own, right? Anyway, there's my airbrush. Thank you, airbrush. Thanks for announcing your presence. But, Tess Fowler gets on Twitter, and she starts talking all kinds of shit about Doug and the fact that Sean Gordon Murphy is going to do a cover for his Bigfoot Bill book. Which I imagine Doug probably hired him to do that. I doubt he did it as a favor, but who knows? Maybe they're best friends. I don't know. And then a few days later, they cancel the cover. And I believe it's done. I believe this is it right here. But now they're not going to do it. It's not going to be on Bigfoot Bill. And so Doug went ahead and drew one himself to put on his book. And I was kind of like shocked. I was like, what the fuck, you know? So Tess Fowler gets to decide who gets to make comics and who doesn't, you know? Why would you take it down? I don't get that, you know? If somebody came along and said, hey, Jeff, I don't like, you know, X, Y, or Z in the way you do things. I'm not saying I wouldn't take something down, but you got to have a good reason. And if your good reason is, oh, I don't like you, well, guess what? Tough luck. It's going to stay up. I went over to Doug's channel and I was watching a couple of his videos trying to figure out what happened. He basically said that he didn't want to mess up any kind of deal Sean Gordon Murphy had with DC. I think he initially said that in his video. And then when he's talking to Comic Book Hut, he said something like DC said something to like Sean Gordon Murphy about working with Doug or whatever. And so anyway, they took it down, you know, and Doug was like, I don't want to cause trouble. And I can respect that, you know. But just as a creator, and especially like a comics creator that's, you know, been around comics for as long as I have and was around comics back in the 90s when Todd McFarlane and Rob Liefeld told Marvel to go fuck themselves and walked out, you know. And watching comic shops get shut down and seeing the, you know, the rise of the Comic Book Legal Defense Fund and stuff like that to sort of fight against those assholes. And it seems like we got a whole new set of assholes out there that think that they can, like, kind of tell us what to do, you know? And I guess I can understand, you know, Sean Gordon Murphy, he's like a big shot at DC, backing off when they tell him to back off. But I guess I can't help but look at it from my own point of view of, like, it seems kind of cowardly. And it seems like it gives this chick, like, a win. So, like, she don't like Sean Gordon Murphy. She don't like Doug Naple. You know, so all she's got to do is complain on Twitter and get her group of, you know, cronies to go and complain. And then, you know, they bow down to her. They do what she says. So then, well, like, who's next? I mean, I really like Sean Gordon Murphy's art, man. His stuff is, like, fucking phenomenal. But then who's next after him, you know? What if it's, like, Frank Miller? What if Frank Miller comes back and starts doing shit? What if it's Alan Moore? Or what if it's, like, Alterna, you know? Everybody seems to really like Alterna and what he does and what he puts out. And what if she says, I don't like Alterna no more. Let's get rid of him. We all got to go, like, well, we never liked Alterna anyway. I think it's really fucking lame, and I wonder how much is, like, just jealousy, you know? I don't like Sean Gordon Murphy. Look at, he gets all this attention. Tess Fowler, I don't get as much. So, like, hey, you know, look at this. I'm gonna fuck with this guy a little bit because he's attaching himself to Doug, and Doug's got a big mouth about, you know, whatever the fuck he's talking about now, you know? I really think everybody ought to come out against Tess Fowler and be like, you know, that's fucking wrong. You owe those guys an apology. And that's pretty much it. You don't get to decide, like, who the fuck works and who doesn't. I mean, that was the whole thing with Mark Wade and Richard Myers, right? Mark Wade doesn't get to be the be-all, end-all gatekeeper to comics. You know, sorry, dude. And Tess Fowler doesn't get to be it either. But anyway, let me tell you about the second part. So when this whole happened, like I said, I didn't know much about Tess Fowler, so I went ahead and did a search. And on YouTube, what comes up but a whole bunch of videos by, you know, Richard Meyer, your boy Zach, that guy. And they're all like a year old. And so I go and I start listening, and I'm like, oh, wow, she's like one of these troublemakers that fired up Comicsgate. You know what I mean? I mean, she's kind of why Comicsgate came into existence. So she was like one of these people who was kind of like in this mob running around, putting down specific creators that they didn't like. For example, Frank Cho. Or remember when Milo fucking Manera, if you don't know who he is, go look his work up. I'll put some on the screen here. This guy right here, look at this guy's art. This guy fucking draws better than 99.9% of anybody working for Marvel right now, I'll guarantee you. And he did a Spider-Woman cover. Remember that? He did a Spider-Woman cover and everybody fucking trashed him for it and was like, oh, you know, you misogynistic bastard. You get the fuck out of comics, all this shit. And they lambasted him. And unfortunately, that was before Comicsgate. And he had nobody that came to his defense. When I heard it about it, I'm like, Milo Manera, are you fucking kidding me? You're like trashing his cover? But my voice is just a small voice, like of one person. It didn't help him any. And he basically got through the wolves for what? Doing like a nice piece. Doing like great art. And I guess their complaint is like, oh, well, he draws naked chicks. He draws like porn comics or whatever. So what? Who fucking cares? What, do you want to go back and retroactively like burn all of Robert Crumb's stuff and throw everything that Richard Corbin did in a big pile in the middle of the street and get rid of it? Give me a fucking break, man. But anyway, you know, it puts me in this quandary because I've gotten so that I don't like Comicsgate anymore. I don't like the way they bully people. I don't like the infighting. I don't like them going after Edwin Boyette. I don't like them going after Mindy Wheeler. I don't like them going after a whole line of people. You know, I don't like dildo memes. I don't like that shit. I'm like, right is right and wrong is wrong. And some of the stuff they're doing is wrong. And I damn sure don't like this idea of like, okay, we can fund comics and not deliver or deliver late and all that shit. That makes those guys look fucking bad. So I don't like all that stuff. But then all of a sudden, here we are being attacked again. You know, just us normal creators just doing our comics, minding our own business, trying to draw what we like. And if what we like doesn't line up with somebody like Tess Fowler, well, you're a fucking asshole and you need to be like deplatformed and taken down. And the only thing that was in between us and them was Comicsgate. You know, so I don't know. You know, sometimes I kind of wonder why I ever kind of started talking to those guys and hanging around those guys. But then in this situation, I'm like, well, fuck. You know, it's because I believed in the original sort of mission of Comicsgate, which was basically to fight against this shit, to sort of draw a line in the sand against fucking people that, like, think that they can tell everybody what to do. I mean, Doug probably was paying a good amount of money for that cover, and I don't know if he still paid him or not, but, you know, you don't know what Sean Gordon Murphy's situation is. Maybe he's got 10 kids. Maybe he lives in some shack out in Alabama or something. Maybe that was like his last $500 this month that was going to pay rent, and it just went bye-bye because this chick decides she don't like him and she don't like who he's working for. You know, it's pretty fucked up, and it's not right. It's absolutely not right. That's it for today, guys. Hit me up on Patreon if you guys want to support the channel. And that's pretty much it. See you guys next time.